What's up, gang? Welcome to another episode of 16 Steps. Today, we're going to be talking about sampling on the Roland MC-909. Here we go. Okay, so we are back with the Roland MC-909. And before we get started, why don't you go down there and click subscribe. Today, we're going to be talking about sampling. This is going to be the sampling section here in the red. Some other things to note are that you have an input trim switch there, trim knob there, and we're going to be doing all of our sampling today through the analog input, and we're just going to be sampling in mono. And today I am using my Novation Base Station 2, and we're going to start by getting some samples off of that thing. So the way to get started here is to simply click the sampling resampling button, and then immediately you're going to see that there are some options down here. There's sampling, resampling, mix, auto divide, and solo. We're going to get into those in a second. First, I just want to walk you through how to get started real quick. You can see there's a meter at the top, VU meter style there. And then there's kind of a graphic that shows the inputs that are selected. So you can see here it has the line left and right selected. And what we're going to do is we're going to go for just this left mono, because that's how we're going to be sampling today. So here we have the line in left, right. And you can hit enter and see all of the options that are there. Or you can just increment, decrement, and you can see there. This is the line in, this is the digital optical input output, and then this is the digital coaxial in and out, and you can sample through those. And then there's microphone, which gives you mic level, so you'll have to gain it a bunch more. If you just use the left right, that is going to be line level. Next, switch is going to be the stereo or mono, and we want to sample in mono today. And then pre-sample time is going to be anywhere up to 1 second. This is milliseconds, so you get 1,000 milliseconds of pre-sample time. So that means that if you happen to miss a second before, it can add that back on. But it only works if you have this checked when you start sampling. Then the next one here is the stop trigger. You can set this to manual, which means you actually have to hit the stop button whenever you start sampling, and then it will stop whenever you hit the stop button. There's beat, which is cool if you need it to be a synchronized with the beat that you're playing. You can sample a bunch of beats. Remember that this is beat and not note, so 16 beats is going to be 4 beats on 4/4. Auto trigger level is going to be if you have this auto trig switch ticked. So you see that the auto trig switch opens up this auto trigger level, and there's 0 through 7 are the range there. And what that is like once it hits a certain level, it will start sampling. It won't start until the sound reaches that level. And then trim switch kind of looks at the sample after you've sampled and kind of cuts it automatically for you, but it's not the best, and sometimes you will frequently find yourself going back to retrim those samples. Gap time is going to be if you're using, if you're going to be dividing the sample, which we'll go into when we're finished with this one. But for right now, we're just going to do mono, no sample, and we're going to do manual start stop. So this is going to be real quick, and then you want to make sure that you're not clipping up here. I like to look at the little VU meters too, just because it's kind of fun. Okay, so today we're doing that Novation Base Station. Let's see. So you don't want it to clip. Ideally, you want it in that range there on these VUs. So here we go. We're gonna do, we're gonna start it, we're gonna sample. All right, let's try that one. That one's cool. Then once I hear it stop, I'll hit the stop. And you can see it has kind of searched for the beginning and end point there. And whenever you are looking at this screen, you can zoom in and out with the cursor keys. This is your horizontal zoom, and then vertical, if you press the shift and then press up or down, you can kind of, you can zoom in, get super tight in there. Also, I will say that I frequently recommend to just use, to try and trim your samples by ear. So you can hear that cuts off. So let's go ahead and look at these parameters. So this is the start point, and it's already moved it to the start, which is handy. Loop start is set to the same as the start point here. However, it doesn't have to be. You can change all of these in the sample parameter menu. Right now we're looking at endpoint. So the endpoint needs to be further out. So let's go ahead and move that. So you can move the scroll wheel, and you can see that the top one is moving very slowly, which is good for fine stuff. And you can see that still cuts off a little bit of our sound. So you can hold down shift and move it, and then it goes a lot faster. Let's try somewhere over there. That sounds pretty good. We can even go ahead and zoom in. You can hit the zoom in out by hitting the F6, and then you can see it that way. And what you're looking at whenever you zoom is going to be the whatever you have selected here. So we're on endpoint there, and so you can see that there's the end. It looks like there's a little bit extra there, although I'm not hearing it in my headphones, so I'm thinking that it's probably okay. But what we're also going to do is we're gonna normalize this, which means to make it as loud as it can be. So for that, I'm going to go ahead and zoom in as much as I can and see what that's looking like. That might just be some noise in line after that, so go ahead and use that. Cool. Now I'll hit truncate, which means to crop it. You want to overwrite, or you can not overwrite, and then it will have the original sample plus the one that is cropped. So that eats up a lot of memory. You want to overwrite, usually. Okay, sample edit. I'm going to go ahead and execute that. Takes a minute. This thing's old. This is the regular view. All right, and now we're gonna normalize it. And again, we're gonna overwrite. Otherwise, you're gonna have like the original, then the cropped version, then the truncated version, or then the normalized version. So we're gonna go ahead and overwrite this again. So we're gonna always try and keep space in mind. Wanna save space. There's our nice loud wave. Oh yeah, that sounds great. So also on this page to look at, you have create patch. There's also sample parameter. Let's take a look at that real quick. Sample parameter, you get loop mode, which is one shot, which means it only plays once. You get reverse, which means it will play it backwards. Cool. Then there's reverse once, so that just plays it backwards one time. If you have reverse, it will continue looping, one shot will just play straight through one time, and then forward will just continue to loop that sound. So that's the loop, but we don't need it looped. You can tune your loop the original key that was sampled at. If you feel like messing with that, you can do that. There's your BPM that it was at, that the machine was set to when you recorded it. There's different types of time stretch. These are helpful for if you want to make effects of, like, you know, time stretch snare drums or whatever. That's cool to do. Or if you need different type time stretch effects for resynchronizing your drum loops, this is where you would experiment and get that set. They also put the BPM in the click right there, so you can, like, listen to the click and make sure that your loop is synced. If you're into doing it that way, that's an awesome way to do it. So right now, we're back to the main screen. There is create patch, which will make a patch out of this sound and put it to whatever part you happen to be on. So this is where you want to make sure that you're on the part that you want to put the sample on, because you can't do it. You can always select it later, but it's good to be on the one that you want it to go on when you do it. So I'm going to go ahead and call this one, let's try insert, and we'll see. We're going to call this one chooser. All right, we'll write that to our card. And so now the patch, which if you look at the, it's going to ask you to assign it to the current part. This is what I was talking about. You can't select another part here. So you want to make sure that you're on the one that you want to put it on early on in the game. The sample that you just made is under that key. So this is spread out over the keyboard. You're free to select a different channel or different part, of course, and then, you know, put the different sound there. But if you need more information on how to program the synth engine, you can always look back at the synth programming video. And it's also same rules apply for the rhythm patches. You can use samples for the tones. So you have four tones, you could have four samples. So we're here. And it's sounding good. Very cool. All right, so this, the actual patch is stored on my card right now. The sample is stored on the internal memory, which means that I can turn it off and turn it back on and the sound will still be there as long as I've saved it. One thing is, like, if you do the truncating and everything, it overwrites it. So you'll see, if you go to edit, you can go sample list, and this is the sample that we're talking about, right? So it's there, and that's what it's called. You can save it as something else if you want and delete that, or you can save the actual samples to your card and have it load it when you boot. It's pretty flexible, but you got to make sure that you're on top of your save game, because it's really easy to lose stuff on this machine by not saving. So heads up, just, I would say, make sure you practice just kind of going through and making sounds, and just be prepared to lose some stuff before you kind of get the hang of where to actually save it and make sure that stuff is saved properly. So we're also going to go ahead and look at these other modes of sampling here. So you got resampling, mix, auto divide, solo. Okay, so resampling is, if you have the machine playing a beat or something, you can hit resampling and sample that beat. You can also, like, you know, if you make a sound and run it through some effects and you do that, then it's going to be, you know, the resampled. And you can also, like, choose how you want those sounds to go routing wise, whether or not you want the effects or the mastering compression on it. Mix will do the entire whatever is playing on this thing plus the input. Auto divide is what we're going to go over next, and that allows you to chop samples just by hitting the auto divide. And then solo is cool because that will let you, like, let's say you have like 16 bars that you want to solo over, or you're going to rap over those or something. You can use solo, and then it will play back and only record what's going into the input and however you have it routed. So let's go into auto divide. We're going to do auto trig, trim switch. Again, there's our level. And the other thing that we should have looked at earlier, but you can see now, is this little graphic will show you how stuff goes. So we got external input. It goes through the mixer and effects. Then it goes to sampling. Then it goes to mix out. So what I want to do, though, is I'm going to turn off all of the samples, all of the mastering and effects. So just so you can see that that's an option. So you can see mix in is off or on. External output assign goes straight to dry. External level left, right. External reverb send level zero. This is where you would set, like, your, like, if you wanted to use an effect on something and just, like, get something crazy affected and then sample it, this is where you would set all of that up. It's very detailed and it's very flexible. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to look at the auto divide feature. We're going to check to make sure that we're in line in. We're at stereo. We need to be in mono. Pre-sample time. Let's go ahead and set this to a little bit before. Stop trigger will be manual. We'll do auto trig. Auto trigger level will be 5. And then we'll go ahead and start. So what I'm doing now is I'm going to use the overlay method on the Novation Base Station 2 to make a little drum kit on here out of samples, but it's going to auto slice all of this for us. So check this out. Right. So there's our sounds. This is just going to be the first sound, of course. Let's see what we got here. So this is what our sound sounds like. Cool. So this is just one of them. And if you want to go ahead and, like, normalize them or whatever you want to do to them, you can go ahead and do each one at a time, which is helpful. For drum sounds, because, like, if you have, like, a stretch of a bunch of sounds and you normalize it, it's just going to make the loudest one as loud as possible, and all the other ones aren't going to be very loud or won't be as loud as possible. You don't have to normalize, but it's very helpful sometimes. So this is our sounds. If you go to sample list, you can see these are the ones that we just created, all these ones that say new and that are mono right here. These are the ones that we just created. So let's go ahead and, like, let's normalize this and then hit normalize overwrite execute. Cool. So there's our sample. You can go ahead and chop this, overwrite it. And then you can look at the other samples in the list. And those should all be set to where they want to be. Make sure we don't have any that are like doubles or weird stuff like that. Cool. Now you can go ahead and let's make sure we get 16 of all of these. And you just go ahead and select these. Another thing that's cool is if you haven't done this like auto chop thing or however you want to call it, auto divide, you can go ahead and just pick whatever samples you want and pick like 16 of them and just make a kit out of it automatically, which is useful. So we're going to go there, hit menu, create new rhythm set, execute. We'll call this one BS-235 because this is not the first Base Station 2 drum kit that I've made. Save it to the card. Hit execute and assign it to patch to part 2. And now we have a whole kit just on there. That key's broken. Cool. All right, well, that was quick and dirty. Hope you found that useful. Please hit me up if you'd like to see demonstrations of other sampling modes or anything like that. Don't forget to subscribe. Hit the like button if you found this useful. And until next time, peace.